Welcome children to the first video of fiber to fabric. In this video you will learn about so many things regarding fibers and fabric. That is, from where does this cloth come, how it is made, what are the types of cloth. Even when, interestingly, if you observe any cloth shop, you might have visited some of the cloth shops. You might have seen so many types of clothes or fabrics. Some may be made up of cotton, some may be synthetic, some may be made up of woolen. There may be so many kinds of clothes like mufflers, shawls, sweaters, shirts, saris, and so on. So the materials from which they are made is totally different. The fabric is totally different. It is different from each other. So cloths are of many types. So many fabrics are made with so many kinds of fibers. Then there may be varieties in the clothes also. Some may be for curtains, some may be for tablecloths, some may be for towels, or some may be for even for some other materials like saris, clothes and bed sheets like this. So by this we can understand that there are so many types of fabrics which are used for making so many things and so many types of the clothes. So here we can say that there are variety in fabrics. So if you observe this picture now, on a bright sunny day, what kind of cloth would you like to prefer to wear? In summer season, we wear the cotton clothes, which are thin and that can absorb water or sweat readily. So thick woolen clothes, synthetic clothes are not suitable for this season. So on bright sunny day or in summer season, we wear very thin cotton clothes which can absorb water very readily. Like that, in winter season or on a winter day, what kind of clothes do you prefer to wear? Certainly not thin clothes, certainly not the clothes that will make you to shear. You will wear, or you will prefer to wear, the clothes like woolen, then synthetic, which are thick, and those which can prevent you from getting the cold. So there is total difference between the clothes that we wear in winter as well as in the summer season, based on the quality of the cloth or the requirement of the season. We used to change the types of the clothes that we wear in a particular season. Now you can observe here, in during the auspicious functions as well as in ceremonial functions, the type of clothes that are worn will be different. People used to prefer synthetic ones made up of silk, synthetic ones that look greater, that will look nice in the functions and the ceremonial functions. So you can find here so many types of clothes. As I told you, clothes are of many types. They may be synthetic, they may be made up of the different type of the clothes like cotton, nylon, then wool, then comes polyester, terricot, then there may be some other synthetic ones like silk or synthetic silk, it may be natural or synthetic, and so on. So the type of cloth that is made from different types of material is a different one, because its type of the mechanism by which it is made is different, and the source is also different, because the clothes are of many types. Based on this, many types of clothes are made and many types of clothes are manufactured according to the requirements of the people. So what are the uses of clothes? Why people use clothes? First thing, requirement of clothes is to get protection against the climatic conditions. The climatic conditions may be extreme hot or extreme cold, or even in icy conditions. Like if snowfalls are there, people have to protect them from the snow and snowfall. Especially people living in equatorial regions, in hot regions of the earth, they are required to wear the clothes which can absorb sweat and water very easily. So thin and cotton clothes are suitable for this season. Then the people who stay in the colder regions, they have to wear the clothes which can protect the body from extreme cold and icy conditions. So there are very essential requirement, the clothes which gives you the protection against the various kinds of seasons. So what are the uses of clothes? Textiles have several uses. The most of the common is for clothing. So clothes are most required for by the people. Apart from other uses, clothes are mostly required in the people because they give protection against the climatic conditions. In the household, textiles are used in carpeting, then furnishing, window curtains, towels, then table corners, bed sheets. Then there are some other clothing also which requires the fabric. According to the type of clothes, uses may be also different depending upon the clothing material. In the workplace, they are used in industrial and scientific processes such as filtering. So clothes, different types of clothes are used to make the type of the cloth and the models based on the requirement. Some may be required to filter the things and some may be required to make the type of the model or type of the cloth which will benefit them for their personal uses and the industrial and the scientific purposes. Based on this, there may be different types of clothing material which can be used at different places like industries and scientific processes. Other uses include flax. Then there are many substances which are used in fabric. They may be synthetic ones along with the natural ones. Means there will be combination of the clothes for getting different types of the combinations. Like other uses of this fabrication will include the flax, then tents, nets, then parachutes and other things. For example, for nets, it may be of a different kind because it is mainly used for catching the fishes and the water animals, like different kinds of fishes. Then the clothing material which is used by sailors in the ships, it may be different because it will be used for moving forward in the seas and oceans. This will be made very easy in moving in the water like seas and the other water bodies. Then parachutes, it's totally different because the parachutes, the clothing that is used in parachutes will be different from the normal one because it will be used in the air. Then the clothing that is used in the kites, especially for game purpose, will be different. For net purpose will be different. For catching fishes it will be different, and for sailing ships it will be different. And the clothing that is used in flags will be totally different. So these are the various requirements of the cloth that requires different types of clothing. Even when you visit a clothing shop, you will also observe different types of clothing materials available. So the clothing material or a fabric, it is made by different types of yarn, that is called as a collection of thread. It is called as a collection of thread. Now you might have observed the thing similar when you tried a thread in a needle. So the type of clothing that is made by using the threads, it is called as a making yarn, that is called as the process by which yarn is made. Now here you can see different types of clothing. That is, what is yarn, you can see here. So what is the yarn means? The end of the thread is separated into a few thin strands because the thread is made up of different strands of a thread. This make it difficult to pass the thread to a eye of a needle. If you take a needle, you can find the thread is made up of simple long individual threads. It is not a single thread, but it is a collection of a thread. So this thread is not able to pass through the needle, the eye of a needle. The thin strands of thread that we see are made up of still thinner strands called as the fibers. So there are different types of clothing material made up of the cloth by the same process. So fabrics are made up of yarns. Yarns are further made up of fibers. Okay. Now the question comes, where from these fibers come? What is the source of a fiber? From where do we get the fibers? So in the picture you are seeing, so many threads are there. So these small threads are called as yarn. And these thin strands that we can see are made up of thinner strands, they are called as the fibers. Then fibers are made up of yarns, and yarns are further made up of fibers. So here we can define a fiber, a material which is available in the form of thin and continuous strand is called a fiber. The thin strands of thread that we see are made up of thinner strands, they are called as fibers. Then you can have a question in mind, what are fibers? Fibers are made up of the yarn, and the yarns are further made up of fibers. Where do these fibers come from? The fibers of some fabrics such as cotton, jute, silk and wool, they are obtained from plants and animals. Now here you can see the fibers are obtained from either plants or animals. So we can see there are two sources of getting the fibers. One is a natural fiber, is a natural source, and the second one is the synthetic one that we call as a man-made fiber or synthetic fiber. So we can divide the fibers into two parts now. One part is the source from plants, and the second part is the source from animals. This means some of the fibers, they are obtained from plants, and some of the fibers, they are obtained from animals. So fibers can be divided into two parts. Here we can divide the natural fibers from the source that we are getting from. So what is a natural fiber? The fibers which are obtained from the plants and animals, they are called natural fibers. They are not synthetic, they are not man-made, so they are called as natural fibers. Natural fibers are the fibers which are obtained from plants and animals, and they are called natural fibers. Examples can be given: cotton, wool, jute and silk. There are four types of fibers which are obtained from natural source. They are cotton, wool, jute and silk. Second one, animal fibers. The common animal fibers are wool and silk. Now, natural fibers are divided into two again. The fibers that are obtained from plants, and the second one, the fibers that are obtained from animals. From plants, we get two types of fibers. First one is cotton, and the second one is jute. From animals, we get two fibers again. First one is wool, second one is called as silk. Wool is obtained either from sheep, goat, yak, camel and other animals. Then silk is obtained from silkworms. Now here little bit information should be given regarding the silkworm. Scientific name of silkworm is Bombyx mori. Scientific name of the silkworm is Bombyx mori. Now the food of this silkworm is mulberry leaves. The silkworm eats or it feeds only on mulberry leaves. It will grow only by eating these mulberry leaves. Once the mulberry leaves are fed to the silkworms, silkworms grow in a required size and then they start producing the silk. For this, the silk thread is in liquid form, which is synthesized or which is prepared in the silicone body. Then the silicone starts producing the cocoon. Cocoon is a round shape form when the threads start spiraling around the animal. Then the animal is inside the cocoon. Once the cocoon is fully formed, it is thrown into the hot water and the silk is separated from the animal. The animal which is present inside, the silicone that is present inside, dies as soon as the cocoon is put into the hot water, hot boiling water. And after that, silk is separated, it is taken out, it is taken to the factories, and further processing is made to get the final silk, out of which clothing or other materials are made. So this is how animals and plant fibers are separated. Now here you can see the man-made, that is what is a synthetic fiber. Synthetic means the one which is made in the factories. The fiber that is manufactured or prepared in the factories by certain chemicals and other things. Other things include colors and dyes. When the synthetic fiber is made, when it is manufactured, it is given the required color so that the colored clothes can be made. So how to define this synthetic one? Man-made or synthetic fiber, both are same. Synthetic fiber is also called as a man-made because it is made in the factories. The fiber that is synthesized in the laboratory are called man-made or synthetic fibers. Examples can be given: nylon, polyester, makhmal and others. They are all the chemical fibers which are made in the factories. They are not the natural ones, they are made in the factories. So fibers, they are natural as well as synthetic ones. Based on this, they can be divided into two parts. Fibers can be divided into two parts: natural ones and synthetic ones. Natural ones, you know, they are obtained either from plants and animals. Plant fibers are of two types. One is cotton, wherein cotton plant gives us the cotton. It can be further separated from the cotton, and after further processing, after getting this cotton, it is taken to the factory, and out of which various fabrics and materials are made in the factory. Second one, we get also jute from natural source, that is from the plants. After taking jute fibers, it is further processed and it is used for making other things. The various kinds of materials are made out of these fibers. The jute fiber is used for making so many things. It is eco-friendly. So natural fibers are always eco-friendly as they do not cause any soil pollution. They are good for health. They are good for using for human beings. Then the synthetic ones, they are called as artificial fibers or man-made fibers. They are made by using chemical treatments. They are used by making chemical treatments. So there are so many types of synthetic ones, that is called as rayon, nylon, polyester or acrylic. All these four types of clothing, it is called as a synthetic one, and which is made up by using the chemical substances. As by and large, we can say that natural fibers or the fibers that are used to make the clothes are always good. That is, the clothing which is made out of using these natural fibers, either by cotton or jute, is always good for the skin and for human use, whereas synthetic clothes are not always good. We will learn further things in detail in the next video regarding the fibers, then cotton, jute, then how cotton is made, what are the processes, what are the steps like spinning, ginning and all these things in the next video.